Greetings to you all. I welcome you all to the second part of the seventh lesson. Now we are going to see about immunology. Study of immune system is called immunology. Immune system refers to all the mechanism used by body for protecting from foreign environmental agents. The immune system will fight against the foreign pathogens and protect our body. This ability is said to be immunity. Lack of immunity is called susceptibility. The main concepts: antigen and antibody. Any substance capable of eliciting the immune response is called as antigen. The protein substances that is generated in our body to recognize and fight against the antigen is called antibody. Types of immunity. Innate immunity, present in our body by birth. It provides resistance. It is non-specific. It is effective against wide range of infections. Okay, non-specific, common for all diseases. Okay, it is also called as natural immunity. Then acquired immunity. Immunity that an individual acquires after birth is termed as acquired immunity by taking vaccination like that. Unique features of acquired immunity: antigenic specificity. It is diversity in recognizing the structure of antigens. Immunological memory, recognition between self and non-self. How the acquired immunity works? There are the two ways through which the acquired immunity works: cell-mediated immunity, antibody-mediated immunity. Cell-mediated immunity. It is the pathogens entering the body are destroyed by immune cells. Underline the word immune cells. Without the production of antibodies. Without the production of antibodies. Immune cells which are involved in cell-mediated immunity are T cells, macrophages, natural killer cells. Antibody immunity. Antibody mediated immunity. The pathogens entering the body are destroyed by production of antibodies. Antibody mediated immunity is brought out by B cells which produce antibodies. Antibody mediated immunity is also called as humoral immunity, and it is the characteristic feature of vertebrates only. Active immunity. In active immunity, the body is involved in immunological resistance by producing antibodies against antigens. Since the person's immune response is used, it leads to the development of memory cells. Active immunity results from an infection or an immunization. Types of acquired immunity. In passive immunity, the body is not involved in producing antibodies. The antibodies are introduced from outside into the body in the form of vaccination. The person's immune response is not activated, used, so there is no memory. Active immunity results from an infection or an immunization. The difference between passive and active immunity. Active immunity is produced actively by host immune system. Passive immunity is received passively and there is no active host participation. It is produced due to active immunity is produced due to contact with pathogen or by antigen. It is produced due to antibodies obtained from outside. Active immunity is durable and effective in protection. Passive immunity is transient and less effective. active immunity. In active immunity, immunological memory is present. In passive immunity, no memory. In active immunity, booster effect on subsequent dose is possible, but in passive, it is less effective. Immunity is effective only after a short period. Passive immunity, immunity develops immediately. Immune response. Immune response refers to the reaction occurring in the body of an organism for the purpose of defending it against pathogen. Types of immune responses: primary immune responses, secondary immune responses. Primary immune responses. Primary immune responses occurs when the pathogen comes in contact with the immune system of organism for the first time. During this, the immune system of body recognizes and produces antibody against it and destroy it. Simultaneously, the memory cells are also generated. Primary response is slow and short-lived. Secondary immune response, it occurs when the body is exposed to the same antigen again. You won't allow the stranger again, isn't it? Like that. During this time, the immunological memory is activated and produced antibodies immediately. Secondary response is very fast. It is long term. It also called the secondary response. See, primary response, very slow and effective. So in secondary response, the reaction is very immediate and the memory is so powerful to eliminate it. Lymphoid organs. Organs involved in origin, maturation, proliferation and storage of lymphocytes are called lymphoid organs. Types of lymphoid organ: primary lymphoid organs, secondary lymphoid organs. Primary lymphoid organs involved in providing proper environment for maturation of lymphocytes. Example: bone marrow in mammal, thymus gland in mammal, bursa fabrics in birds. Bone marrow. It is a lymphoid tissue. Bone marrow is the spongy portion of bone tissue found inside the bones. They contain special stem cells called hematopoietic cells, that is the cells which can form blood cells, RBC, WBC. These cells has the potential to differentiate and produce any kind of blood cells. Bone marrow, if you take mutton, there is one bone called nulli bone. Inside that you can, when you have that bone, you will have a black color bone marrow. That is said to be bone marrow tissue, it is very good for health. Thymus gland, flat bilobed organ, located behind sternum above the heart. Look at the picture. The lobes are further divided into lobules. The lobules have outer cortex and inner medulla. Cortex has immature T cells. Medulla has mature T cells. Thymus secrete thymosin hormone, which are immunocompetency to the T cells. Thymus is active mainly during neonatal and pre-adolescent period. Neonatal before birth, pre-adolescent before adolescent period. Secondary lymphoid organs. These are the structures where antigen is localized so that it can be effectively changed into lymphocytes. Spleen, lymph nodes, appendix, Peyer's patches, tonsils, adenoids, malt, galt, balt, that is mucus associated lymphoid glands, cells. Then galt means gut associated. Then next one is lymph node. Lymph nodes are small, pear-shaped structures. Hundreds of lymph nodes are found in the body. They are connected by lymphatic vessels. Lymph is colorless, extracellular fluid and connective tissue. Like blood, it is white in color and it runs throughout our body. Lymph node has three zones: cortex zone with B cells, macrophages, dendrite cells; paracortex zone with T cells and dendritic cells; medulla with plasma cells. When the lymph fluid enters the lymph node, it passes through the three zones, during which the antigen in lymph fluid are filtered and trapped by lymphatic cells. Swollen lymph nodes. Swollen lymph nodes indicate the active immune response. It may be a signal of infection. Enlargement usually occurs at the lymph nodes of armpit, under chin, neck and groin. Cells of the immune response. White blood cells are the group of cells involved in immunity. Lymphocytes are the white blood cells concerned majorly in immune response. Lymphocytes. It constitutes 20-30% of white blood cells. Cells possess large nucleus. Types: B lymphocyte, T lymphocyte. B cells are produced, proliferated and gains immunocompetency in bone marrow. So B cells. T cells are produced in bone marrow and gains in thymus and immunocompetency in thymus. Thymus, first letter T, T cells. B cells provide antibody mediated immunity by producing antibodies. T cells provide cell mediated immunity. Immunogen, a substance capable of initiating an immune response. Captains, response are called immunogen. Heptanes, non-immunogenic substance but can react with the product of specific immune response. Adjuvants, substance that enhance immune response. Epitope, active part of an antigen where the antibody binds. Paratope, the active part of an antibody which recognizes and binds to an antigen. Antigen, what are antigens? Antigens are large complex molecular substances that can induce immune response, and also it is the one that react with antibodies. Types of antigens: exogenous antigens and endogenous antigens. Antigens entering the host from outside. Endogenous antigens found within the host body. Antibodies, protein molecules synthesized on exposure to antigen. Antibodies are highly specific to antigen. They are produced by plasma cells. They are also called as immunoglobulins. Types of antibodies: Ig alpha, Ig immunoglobulin. Ig stands for immunoglobulin. Ig delta, Ig gamma, Ig epsilon, Ig mu. In short, to have it in memory, we can say Ig game D, G for gamma, A for alpha, M for mu, E for epsilon, game D. Okay. Chemical structure of antibody, very important question. Y-shaped structure, made up of 4 polypeptide chains, 2 light chains and 2 heavy chains. Light chain has approximately 214 amino acids with 25,000 Dalton. Heavy chain has approximately 450 amino acids with 50,000 Dalton. The polypeptide chains are linked by disulfide bonds. Each chain has 2 terminals, carboxyl terminal and variable region. Carboxyl terminal and non-carboxyl. Then Each chain has two regions, variable region and constant region. The C region form the stem, and it is same for all. The V region differs from every antibody, and antigen-antibody interaction. The reaction between antigen and antibody forms the basis of humoral immunity. Antigen-antibody interaction occurs in three stages. Stage 1, formation of antigen-antibody complex. They join together. Then occurrence of antigen-antibody reaction. Then destruction or neutralization of antigen. Antigen killed. Okay. Then binding force of antigen-antibody interaction. The binding between the antigen-antibody depends on three factors. One, closeness between antigen and antibody. Next, non-covalent bond or intermolecular forces. Then affinity of antibodies. Types of antigen-antibody reaction. First one, opsonization. Pathogens are marked by antigens and engulfed by phagocytosis. Phagocytes engulf like amoeba. Then next one, precipitation. Makes soluble antigens insoluble, aiding elimination. Make them to settle and easily they can be eliminated. The next one, agglutination. Links cell-bound antigens together, causing clumping. The next one, neutralization. Masks dangerous parts of pathogen. Example, exotoxin. Then inflammation. Triggers histamine release, increasing immune mobility. Inflammation, vingrathu. The next one, complement. Complement. Complement protein perforates the cell membrane. Then vaccines. Vaccine is a biological preparation that provides active acquired immunity to specific disease. Vaccines teach our body how to defend against the specific disease. Vaccine initiates immunization process in our body. Vaccines generally contain weakened or attenuated or killed forms of microbes, their toxins, or any of its surface microbes. These components are recognized by our immune system and generate immunity without actually experiencing the disease. Types of vaccine. Live attenuated for tuberculosis, oral polio vaccine, measles, rotavirus, yellow fever. Inactivated killed antigen, whole cell perfuses and inactivated polio viruses. Subunit, acellular pertussis, Haemophilus influenza type B and pneumococcal hepatitis B. Then toxoid, tetanus toxoid, diphtheria toxoid. DNA vaccine, PVAC. Difference between vaccination and immunization. Vaccination is the administration of vaccine, that is antigenic material, to stimulate an individual's immune system to develop immunity to specific disease. Immunization is a process by which a person's body builds up its immunity towards specific disease. Hypersensitivity, the exaggerated immune response of our body to a certain substances. Hypersensitivity is also called as allergy. Allergic reactions are mediated by IgE and mast cells. Any substance that causes allergy is said to be an allergen. Example for allergen, mites, dust, pollen, food items, etc. Symptoms of allergic reaction are sneezing, itching, headache, breathing, rashes, etc. Anaphylaxis, a sudden, systematic, severe, extreme, immediate hypersensitivity action. Then immunodeficiency diseases. Immunodeficiency diseases are due to the failure of one or more components of immune system. Types of immunodeficiency diseases. Primary immunodeficiency disease caused due to genetic defect. Secondary immunodeficiency disease caused due to exposure to radiations. Use of immunosuppressive drugs or due to infections. Acquired immune deficiency syndrome, that is AIDS. AIDS is a immunodeficiency disease occurred by viral infection. AIDS is not a congenital disease. AIDS is caused by human immunovirus HIV. HIV infects the helper T cells, thereby preventing the stimulation of B cells to produce antibodies, leading to loss of natural defense against infection. HIV belongs to the genus lentivirus. Here is the structure. It is spherical shaped. Size is 100 to 120 nanometer in diameter. Composed of core protein and an envelope. Envelope is made up of glycoproteins GP41 and GP120. Core protein is covered by capsid protein and further by matrix protein. Core portions contain ssRNA double bond attached with reverse transcriptase. Transmission by unprotected sex, pregnancy and childbirth, and breastfeeding, injecting drugs, working in a healthcare area, then blood transfusion and organ tissue transplants. Diagnosis for human immunovirus. ELISA test confirmed by Western blood test. Now qPCR. Prevention of HIV. Safe sex practices. Avoid multiple partners. Regular checkup. No sharing of razors or syringes or toothbrushes. Check the blood before transfusion. AIDS awareness program. Then next one, tumor immunology. Tumor is otherwise called as cancer. Tumor or neoplasm is a group of cells showing unchecked growth. When tumor cells continues to grow and invade the other healthy cells, it produces cancer. Types of cancer or tumor: benign tumor, malignant tumor. Benign tumor, non-cancerous with limited growth. Malignant tumor, cancerous and unlimited growth, exhibit metastasis. Cancer cell, see the cancer cell, this one is normal cell. Contact inhibition and cancerous growth. Contact inhibition is a special property of normal cells. It inhibits the cells from uncontrolled growth. Cancer cells do not have this contact inhibition property, and as a result, they undergo continuous division of cells. C. Immunological surveillance. Immunological surveillance is a monitoring process of our immune system to seek and destroy the malignant cells that arise by somatic mutation. Presence of effective immunological surveillance will prevent the occurrence of cancer. Development of tumor represents a lapse in surveillance. Immunotherapy is a kind of cancer treatment. Tumor cells bind to T cells to deactivate them. Immunotherapy drugs can block tumor cells from deactivating T cells. That's all for today, and we can meet in the third part of lesson 7 again. Okay, thank you.